Spartan Spotlight, where we bring you all things regarding AU athletics. I'm Kevin Berger. Today on the show, we have Ty Carlson and Pat Cramp. Pat and Ty, along with the Aurora University men's basketball team, are coming off a NAC tournament championship where they've received an automatic bid to the NCAA tournament this weekend. Thank you both for returning and joining us again today.
Thanks for having us.
So, guys, let's just go back to the first time you guys were here earlier in the season. And I asked you guys what your goals were for the season this year. And you guys said to win conference, among other things, if I remember correctly. So how has that gone for you this year?
It actually went really well. We accomplished all of our team goals. We wanted to win the conference regular season and win the conference tournament. And we did that, and which ultimately means we get to play in the national tournament. So. That's always our goal here.
And just a follow-up question to that. So from this season, what is your guys' favorite memory, whether it team, personal, both? So what are your guys' favorite memories from this season?
I'd probably just say the conference tournament as a whole. I mean, both Friday and Saturday night, the atmosphere was unbelievable. The fans were on 10, and we played really well, and it was a lot of fun. We got two huge wins in front of the home crowd. Got to cut down the nets, and that's something that's a really special memory.
Ty?
I'd have to say just the overall journey. I think we were sitting in the locker room after Albion where we had a loss over Christmas break, and we were 5-6. Mm-hmm. So, you know, just kind of turning that around, and I think we've won 9 straight now and then won the conference tournament. So just being a part of that was pretty sweet.
So would you describe that as the turning point almost in your guys' season where you more or less figured out what type of team you guys were going to be this season?
I would say definitely. And then, you know, we came back after a week off, and then we got to play Wisconsin Lutheran at home, and we scored 70 points in the first half. So, yeah. You know, it just really motivated us to put in the work and get better.
And going to the conference tournament, Pat, you mentioned the conference tournament as well. How did it feel to not only beat Benedictine and Hobart, you guys beat them twice in one season. So how did that feel, just as, you know, because it's a big rivalry between AU and BU. How'd that feel?
Yeah, it felt really good. They've had a number the past couple of years. We hadn't beat them since our freshman year, actually, so it felt really good. I mean, it's always nice to beat a rival or get a conference win at home, but that one felt really good. And then especially, like you said, the conference tournament championship, just because, you know, you can't script it any better. Yeah. To a huge rivalry game, you know, the stage was set, and we went out there and performed.
Of course. Moving on, so you guys are a couple of the seniors on the team. What are you guys going to miss most about maybe this core group that you guys have been with for these last 4 years? What are you guys going to miss most about playing here?
I'm just going to miss the people. I mean, I've met so many amazing people in my time here, teammates, coaches, trainers, whatever it might be. And just being around them on a day-to-day basis is so awesome because they all just have different personalities and they bring something else to the table.
I have to piggyback off that with the people. Just, I mean, you walk around campus and everyone's saying, hey, good game Saturday, or all the professors come up to you in class and say, you know, it was great seeing you out there and stuff like that. So it's really cool, the atmosphere we've built here.
And Ty, I believe you're actually playing another season. You're playing next year, right?
Yeah, I'm getting my MBA this upcoming summer into next spring, so I'll be playing again.
So is it going to be a little bit different without guys like Pat, Justin? Is it going to be different without all those guys that you've grown really close to the last 4 years being there? Is it going to feel any different?
I think it will. I mean, Pat and Justin both bring a lot of leadership. They're four-year guys. I mean, Marcus and some more seniors will be gone. But, you know, with Pat and Justin gone, Max, Matt Dunn, and I, we're going to have to step up the leadership role. Yep. And then kind of just develop it there.
So when you guys first got, I'm going to take you guys back to freshman year a little bit. When you guys first got here, the team had, let's be honest, they had some really good talent on the team. We don't really need to go over the names. I think we did that the last time you guys were here. But did you guys envision yourselves being able to do something that they couldn't with you guys going to the national tournament, not just winning the conference tournament?
I think it was just set out. I think it was a goal right from the get-go because they always talked about when they won the conference as sophomores that it was just an awesome year. And, you know, they were able to go out there and win the conference tournament. And then the NCAA tournament is just also a great experience. So I think it was just kind of a goal of ours from the beginning. So I think we just knew we had to do whatever it took to get to that point.
And this year I think we clinched our 25th consecutive winning season. So I don't even think we've missed the conference tournament. So we knew that the opportunity every year was going to be there. We just had to capitalize, and we got to do that.
Very nice. And going into this game against, I believe it's Washington University in St. Louis this Friday, you guys got any kind of scouting report that you guys can give us on what you guys are going to be expecting and what we can expect as fans this this weekend.
Well, they're the number four team in the country right now, sitting at 22-3. They lost the last game of the season. There's no conference tournament for them, but they're a really good team. They're big. They can pound the ball inside. They can shoot it pretty well. There's really not many flaws to their game, but they're definitely beatable. And you know, I think if anybody's going to do it, it's going to be a team like us.
Any given night, you know. Okay. Well, thank you guys both for joining us. Be sure to check in next week as the Spartans will be traveling to St. Louis, Missouri this coming weekend to take on Washington University. Tip-off at Friday's game is set for 7:30 p.m. Now let's take a moment to check out some highlights from this past weekend's tournament with video produced by Jalen Prince. Stay tuned.
You know what it was when you signed up.
Welcome back. I'm Cody Murtaugh. Joining me are two members of our AU Spartan Spotlight team, Kevin Berger and Ryan Craig. Kevin and Ryan this semester have been working on something a little bit differently, so can you two kind of take us through like what your sports podcast has been for your senior capstone and just kind of what that's been like and how that came about?
Yeah, I'll go first.
Yeah.
Our show is called Mopes and Hoodies, although we're not wearing hoodies today.
No, we're not, ironically enough. We'll get into that later.
But we basically cover sports, and sometimes we dive into different things. We do trivia.
We did do trivia.
We do heated topics and all kinds of stuff going around.
Yeah, we've had a couple story times, too, on there.
Yeah.
So.
Good ones.
Yeah, pretty good.
What were the story times like?
Story times, it was more or less, you know, just about the events that happened to us over the course of that weekend. At one point, one of us, we got into, we got into a dispute with somebody else.
One of us.
Got into a dispute with someone else and, just told that story as to how that happened, what happened afterwards, and the results were, well, they spoke for themselves.
So what happened was, Kevin came into the podcast room and we're having our show and I just wanted to know why he's got a black eye. And then he told me our story. So
yeah.
Then we just had, you know, regular conversations about
right.
our weekends and stuff like that. Sometimes we get into, you know, topics like who's the greatest sport team or
yes.
whatever. But
like we had almost a show that was an entire segment dedicated to our top 10. We had like top 10 most dominating players in
right.
whatever their sport is, best athletes, best dynasties. So it can be anything from that to we talk about the Chicago sports scene, obviously, because, you know, we're in Aurora, not too far from Chicago, as such as it is right now.
Although it's awful, yes.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yes.
A little bit. So You guys mentioned it a little bit. The title of your podcast is Mopes in Hoodies. Where did that come from? How did you guys come
up
with that?
I'm going to lend that straight over to this guy because he's the guy that came up with the name and I liked it. So.
Well, I would also have to pass that off because I didn't come up with the name. I just chose to use the name. So the definition of a mope is someone who's basically just up to no good. They just lay around, don't really do very much. They're kind of just up to no good all the time. And my dad affectionately always calls me and whoever my friends are mopes. So I said instead of the Men in Blazers show that talks about Premier League soccer, he said, oh, you guys should do mopes and hoodies. I'm like, well, that's perfect. So I brought it up to Ryan, and Ryan thought it was a good idea. Mm-hmm. So I guess that's how it is. Yeah. Of course, right. The whole part is that we don't have hoodies on.
Every single time I come into the studio, I rarely have a hoodie. But I always wear flannel. I'm a flannel guy, so... We always have segments at the end of the show, and Kevin being mad at me. So
yeah,
I mean, hey, it's a podcast. No one knows whether you're wearing your hoodie or not. So that's all right.
So,
But can you guys run us through just kind of a typical show? You've talked about a little bit, but like, what are listeners guaranteed to hear every time you guys are on together?
Oh well, we usually find arguments somehow. So like we stated before, our typical show, we'll start it off, we have our intro music, obviously, and then we'll get into regular topics that come into sports. Like, as of today, we have an issue going on in NCAA basketball with their scandal with paying players. Mm-hmm. That would be a segment. If we did one today, that would be a segment that we would get into. We would get into the Bulls and what's going on with them.
Bears with their new staff, the Blackhawks, Cubs and Sox have both gone to spring training now.
Right.
Then we generally, depending on the subject area, we'd probably touch, you know, league-wide. Like, the NBA is very hot right now because they're getting into their playoff push. The NHL is getting into the playoff push. MLB is just starting to heat up. So then, and we even talked about the Olympics for a little while.
Oh, yeah. It was a good segment. Kevin doesn't like when I bring in the Cubs music, though.
No, I don't.
Go Cubs.
Right. Well, speaking of which, what has been your favorite show for the both of you so far working together on the podcast?
Oh, I would have to say probably our most recent one when we had that top couple players.
Yeah, we had, it was the list segment where it was top players and various positions. Cause we almost wanted to break it down by position too, especially in the NBA, we broke it down by position. So who do we think was the best point guard of all time? Who's the best small forward, et cetera.
And then we concluded that show with who we would pick our top five for Madden.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So if any of you guys know, you know, playing Madden is such a big deal, especially when you're, you know, college students. So we picked our top five. That was a pretty fun segment.
Yeah. So after having done a few of these podcasts now, it is for your senior capstone, but would you guys consider continuing on afterward? Like, have you thought about maybe trying to keep doing this, whether it was with each other still or doing different podcasts?
Oh, definitely. I think radio and podcasts would definitely be, like, an avenue I've always wanted to do. I've done a couple internships at radio, and I've always been a sports enthusiast, you know, just like Kevin over here. So, and if we, by chance, down the road, would able to be, you know, getting our own show, that would be really cool. Although we don't have the luxury of having our own podcast show, you know, after graduation, but down the road, that'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, same thing with me. I've always been interested in sports. 4-year athlete here, and I also I've broadcasted games for the school here, so I already have experience doing that. Podcasting and radio, it allows, I feel like, especially podcasting, more freedom to the personalities that do them. Like, me and Ryan, I don't think there's a show like ours because it's more free-flowing. We kind of play it by ear. I mean, we have a script that we go through every day, and we stick to it as best we can. But if one of us brings up a different point, then we dive into that, and eventually we bring it back to that point. But it's very free-flowing, and it's a lot of fun. I would love to keep doing that if I had the chance to.
Yeah, we're lucky to have, a good communication process where we're, like, you know, we're friends, so we bounce things off each other. We even go off the script a lot of times.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we can get a little preview of what the podcast is like by me asking, what is each of your favorite athletes of all time and why?
I'm going to let you go first.
Oh, okay, hot potato. Okay, I would have to say I got to put up Michael Jordan. Mm-hmm. You know, go Bulls. Mm-hmm. If I had to pick a Cubs player, it would probably be Sammy Sosa.
All right, interesting choice. What about you, Kev?
Best athlete that I've ever watched. See,
I didn't get the chance to watch Jordan in his prime. That's the only reason why I won't say that. So I'll say Michael Phelps. And I guess since football is my thing, my favorite football player that I've ever seen play is probably, I'd have to give it to Ray Lewis.
Ooh.
That's a good choice. So for the people watching the show today, is there somewhere they can go to listen to your podcast if they're interested based on this?
There is.
Yes. So we have a Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
So we have a YouTube channel.
Yes, and also a YouTube channel you can subscribe. You can go to Mopes and Hoodies for both of our podcasts. I mean, both of our social media realms. So, yeah.
And YouTube, you guys just type in Mopes and Hoodies. It'll be, I think it's like the second thing that pops up.
Yes. So definitely share that. That'd be really cool.
Yeah, awesome. Well, hopefully everyone will check that out then. Thank you both for being on the show today. That's all the time we have on Spartan Spotlight. Join us next time and be great today, Spartans. If you'd like to show your love for Spartan Spotlight or have suggestions for us or would like to be on the show, find us on Twitter at AU Spartan Media. And a big thanks to our guests, Pat and Ty, for being on the show today, as well as Kevin and Ryan for sharing a little bit about their podcast. I'm your host, Cody Murtaugh. Until next time.